going to show you how to make a mint julep today. Why is everything on YouTube perfect? The best ever. The perfect. You know, it's subjective. There's no such thing as the perfect mint julep. Well, if there was, this would be it. This would be the perfect mint julep for me. That's all I'm saying. So today, on Cooking with Vinny, Drinking with Vinny, we're going to make a mint julep because there's so much mint coming up. So let's go to the kitchen and make a mint julep. I mean, this is, actually, we've already made the mint julep because here it is. This is the proof positive. We've already made the mint julep. Salute. Look at this beautiful mint. All this comes from outside here, fresh. And we're going to make a simple syrup infused with the mint. This keeps you away from muddling. You don't have to muddle if you got the infusement inside the simple syrup. How simple is a simple syrup? Well, I'll tell you. You go with 2 cups of water, 2 cups of organic sugar, that's the way I like it, and then you sort of bring the heat up on that, and you melt it, and then you, when all the sugar is completely dissolved, boom, you got yourself a simple syrup. What we're going to do today is we're going to infuse the simple syrup with mint. Chop this up, chop the mint up, and I'm going to throw the mint in top of all this. We'll boil it for a little bit, huh? And then let it steep for a while to get the mint infused into the simple syrup. Now, what you then do is use a simple syrup in your basic mint julep recipe, but you can also take that same mint-infused simple syrup, add some water and some lime, and you got a mojito mix, huh? Then you put a little bit of rum in, a little bit of rum, oh, and of course you're using the limes with that. A lime for the mojito. This is some great, beautiful, single barrel bourbon right here. This is beautiful stuff. This is the Blanton's, and look at this. It's even got a little horsey right on there, so you can take this to Churchill Downs with you next time you're there. What I'm going to use, though, instead, because this is sipping stuff here, this is what you want to do with it. You want to just sip it. And it's so smooth. This is only like 93 proof. Look at this. This is the Knob Creek single barrel bourbon. It's 90 years old, but look at this. This is the cool part right here. This is 120 proof. That is 60% alcohol. That's the kind of math I can do. 120 proof, boop, 60% alcohol. That's some good stuff. The reason I'm using this, it's hard for me to sip this because it's pretty strong. But if you put it in a drink, it's going to get watered down with some ice and some syrup and stuff. It's perfect. All the flavor is there. You're not watering it down. Well, you are watering it down, but you're taking it from 120 proof, boop, and you're bringing it back down to something that you can handle. I ain't saying that you couldn't handle 120 proof. Many of you can. But you can take a couple of leaves here, put it in the bottom of the glass. Then, this is some simple syrup I made last week for the Kentucky Derby. About an ounce. It's like a 3-to-1. That's the way I like it. 3 parts bourbon to 1 part simple syrup. Infused simple syrup. So you got that in here, you can muddle if you want. See, now you gotta find something to muddle with. Do you have a muddler? Is that the right word, muddler? Can you say muddler? You got a muddler? I don't know, do you got one? So you use like a wooden spoon or something. See? That looks like a good muddler to me. So what do? You get you push the mint down, that's what you're doing. Ice out of here. See, now you got the, on the bottom there, there's that crushed stuff. One, two, three. Oh, that's tasty. And see, then you can adjust the ice there. You want to get it cold. Now, what I like to do, sometimes a little bit of soda. Just a little bit.
Salute.
Huh? Mm. This is an incredible buzz. Especially when you're taking Percocet.
Ooh.
Hey, don't try this at home. I got a back problem. It's not bothering me right now.